Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for joining us again for this month's installment of Kanikapila in Kailua. We want to welcome any one of you as a part of this monthly series. The La Hula Mat is not specifically for hula, so if you want to just stretch out and be all relaxed, La Hula Mat is for. Don't want to invite anyone in the back or sitting around if you want to get comfortable and walk on the mat. That's okay. We set that up for that purpose. So go ahead and relax and find a spot there if you want. There you go. We'll get started in just a couple of minutes.
Big hand for Jerry Santos. Come on. Can you imagine how things happen? Still, Go outside, So you're a province of 96744. I know Kailua is 3-4.
Almost me. I don't want to start over.
But while we're happy to be now in Kailua, we certainly are going to get a lot of all of it. Where the poor and the poor is the sweetest, and the Kailua people will debate that until the cows come home. Not as many cows as the word of it is.
Yeah.
inside of me. The Kalahulu that I grew up with was only accessible on a highway, so you couldn't get into too much trouble. My mother would say, somebody told me this one on the road, it's not going to be. Yeah. except that Mark is something something with the very first hole on the novel. That was 1976. How many of you were alive? That song really wasn't growing up song for me because I, a few days later I found myself on a plane coming home. I had made the right choice because I knew that the world could be a place to go and have adventures, and I could live where I wanted to and where I felt the most comfortable. And so far, in over 50 years of making music and traveling around the world, it's worked out quite well for me. But the other thing that was obviously a right choice for me is that when I got home, a friend of mine got in touch with me that I had known from the earlier days, and he said, I have this group that I'm starting, and I want you to come and play music with me. And I thought, okay, I'll keep my job 4 nights a week, I'll play with you 3 nights a week, and we'll see if one works out. His name was Robert Beaumont, and he grew up right down the road over here, keep up on the road. And it turns out that Robert introduced me to many Kanikapila people that allowed us to have a career, a great career in music. Unfortunately, Robert left us way too soon. I worked with him from 1975 until 1982. But during that time, we recorded quite a bunch of music, and seeing those old album covers made me think of something else. So, I just went through a little while with him. And more importantly, the metaphor of the lay is a very precious one. Like sometimes we take the idea of the lay for granted and not in the way. When you make a lay for somebody, you're not just sowing flowers. You're attaching your best intentions, love, consideration, respect, care. It all goes into the making of the lay, and when it's given, and all goes to the hearts of it, we hope all that transfers. And in that spirit that you gave us this song, you remind us that long after the flowers are given, long after the physical elements are covered, the intention that went into the making of the relationship, the intention that went into the making of the lay continues. Because that is the love of the spirit, it's a kind of love on and the call of all of us. It's always there for us in the lay. As I just mentioned. And today, people gather all together to say aloha to some very special people in our world. And to all may be the Hawaiian aloha. It means the message in all the Aave for anybody who saw the digital name over many decades of music. It was that to all standing right next to her mercy. And had a very long life. She left us at today. Church of Latter Day Saints in Manawa with Seko. At a Kailua church without a Honolulu, people gather to say goodbye to her and be sorry. Anybody who has loved Hawaiian music knows that really long historians, everything was one of those people who reminded us where Hawaiian music came from, how we can move into the time, and where it goes in the future. And over in Kailua, we can say goodbye to my cousin, my sisters. So we sing for our brother, for Willie, for all of you that we love. Visit us on every occasion like this, and in our own lives at the same time.
Thank you.
these words of love say that you ask us to follow me.
My granddaughter is pulling one of her lucky names. Pride is for life, my bath and body. And I can read the name poor, but the rest of the name is written like in kanji. No, this Kamal, if you can decipher that, you're amazing.
Kua, and the last name starts with an H. Kua H, you there. You gotta rewrite your name the same way. Prove your signature.
To verify. How's up behind for Kua?
Listen.
Kailua Town Beach Town and a CD to Noreen Green. So I want to let you all know that there's been a change up in next month's schedule. I was scheduled to perform here with our local working group, Kulaivi, but we're not going to be here next month. We are hosting three Slacky artists, Jeff Peterson, Ian O'Sullivan, and Hamwala Kimokia.
Hamwala.
And Hamwala. Hamwala. Right. He was ready for that. So join us again. Second Saturday of next month, October. Once again, we're so blessed to have our considered legendary Jerry Santos and Kamwala Kimokia joining us today. Thank you.
Thank you so much for all of you. Thank you so much for all of you. Thank you so much for letting us all come together. Thank you, Mark. We started all of that old rock music with your album this afternoon. I hope you take responsibility for all of it. On behalf of my daughter, I'm our fashion designer, and the back of the room will give us these shirts. Come on, I'm going to
do it. Yeah. One of the big graphics.
We've been sharing some songs with you and some stories about our place down the road. But, you know, Kailua has a very special place in my heart. Daddy was a janitor at Kailua Elementary School when we were growing up. You know, people went hard to try and put food on the table for their children. And so I started school before I was in kindergarten because I came to school with my older sister and they just let me stay in the classroom.
It's not a thing anymore.
I know, that's so much of a problem. And my auntie and I, they've got over 2 years now behind a boy. So we would come visit her and spend the day at the Kailua Beach. Over the years, you know, Kailua certainly has changed for those of you who are from this area. And watched it grow over the years. How important it is to continue to tell our stories. For the face of them that may change, but in the music, in the life stories, lies the connection to the land. And if we want people to feel the way about our home that we did, maybe some time ago, we have to continue to share our stories with each other. And over on this side, we have with us the some people who will do just that. Many of you have to learn about flirting a little bit. And all of our Ohana, all the girls, we have that every day, who will raise time while with their music for many years. And down the road on that week is a husband and wife team, the practitioners of Hula. And for those of us who are interested in the stories and connections that take us back in time, certainly we are grateful to Bokuana and KABC for doing just that and reminding us of the old days. It is said that he rewrote this song for his grandchildren so that they would know when they went out to the mall without having the money what the names of the places were when he wasn't there. And if they say they grew up with him, might be coming up. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.
Santos, Kanikapila. Good man. Earlier, Jerry mentioned to me, for many years prior, he had no garage at the house he lived at. I told him, treat this jam like you're in someone's garage. He now has a house that has a garage, so.
I don't know, you know, people have garages, not me.
One final aloha to Jerry and Kamala. Also with a big hand.
Thank you. Thank you.